Good day, friends. It is me, HLModTech, and I am back with another awesome Tinkercad tutorial. So let's get cracking. Friends, here we have a sweet Rube Goldberg machine that was created by Brooklyn from Mrs. Ross Davis's classroom. Now, friends, these are a ton of fun. Let me show you how they work in SimLab. Friends, after a moment, your project will load, and then it's time to make parts static. So if we look over here, this piece that holds the lever that moves back and forth, it has been made static. Anything in your design you need to do that to, of course, Brooklyn has already done that. Now here we get to the problem. When you hit play, this project, which is absolutely amazing, and we're trying to test it, takes more than 5 minutes to run. Now I'm going to use fast speed to show you how it records the entire time, but you cannot export the full 5 minutes, so I'm going to show you another way to record it after you've been successful, and then turn that into a fun video. So friends, this is a real part of the project. This is fast mode, but as it gets around this corner, after about 2 minutes, it stops. It didn't work. So we have to back up and start again. Having to back up and relaunch as you get it configured correctly is a common thing, so you need to get used to that. Another thing that you can do is have a separate tab where you're working while you're letting this play, because it's not that fun watching the slow motion version go through it. But as you can see, I backed up and let it go again. Here comes the fast mode. Once again, I am speeding this up after it was done using video editing. In real life, this took 8 minutes, but you can see right there we finally had success. It comes around the wow and comes back, splits, comes up. You'll notice there is a tiny glitch on the W, but it finally finishes. Do note, I never wiggled this, I just let it run and finally hit pause. Now that we have our successful run through, let me show you a slick way to record it. We're going to visit Clipchamp. If you've never signed in before, simply choose sign in with Google. Bingo, we are in Clipchamp, and I want to choose the create new video option. Looks like we have a new ability, editing multiple items. We will explore that later. First, let me show you how to capture our screen. Do make sure you allow your microphone if you want to, and also you may want to allow a webcam. I am not going to be recording voice, so that's no big deal. So once again, I click screen, and then we go down here and click on the record button. The system asks us whether we want a tab or a window. I want a tab, and I'm going to bring up the one with my sweet recorded SimLab project. Now don't forget, we can just slide this all the way back, and friends, when we hit play, now we will have a quick play of this Rube Goldberg machine. Notice this time everything happens way more efficiently. I can also move the angle to catch it from any spot that I want. It is still a long project as the dominoes all go through, but you'll notice it is so much faster than it was when it was recording the first time while the SimLab was working through it all. Now another fun thing about this is we can change the angles as it goes. I'm letting it play through this time, but let me show you how you can record multiple versions so later in Clipchamp you can stitch it together to make an epic final project of your Tinkercad SimLab Rube Goldberg machine. Round the corner we go, and check it out, here we are with the ending. Finally, click stop sharing so you can play with your footage. This version took a little over a minute instead of the 8 minutes when we were testing it. Once you're done, friends, we do need to switch tabs, click save and edit. I'm going to choose to save mine to my downloads folder, and then boom, you will have it available in your media for creating your awesome final video. Alright friends, so remember we had that little glitch down here at the W? I have just added another piece and turned the angle just a little bit, so I think that might be successful. Once again, friends, now we click on SimLab. I'm going to zoom out once it enters, and I'm just going to hit play and hope for success. Once again, have other tabs available so you can do something else, because it takes several minutes for this thing to run through before we finally hit pause, and then we can record our footage a second time. Friends, after letting it play for another 8 minutes, check it out. I have got a working one. I did make another mod. I'll show you that real quick. There you can see the W plays exactly like it was supposed to. And let me spin it around and show you this right here. I took this ball and I made it rubber. I made this one steel and I made this one wood. So that way when they come through, there's a little more impact. And bam, that worked just like it was supposed to. So friends, now that we've got the new one recorded, you can return and do the same steps in Clipchamp to record this again and again from every angle. So right here, I'm gonna right click pan and I'm gonna zoom in and say I wanted to show this piece successfully. I would get the scrubber to right here and then I would simply start recording, hit play, and bam, I would have another chunk of footage showing that. If I back it up and I spin it to the other side, I can even get a view from this angle showing the exact same action but from a different angle. It's so easy to capture so many awesome views of your awesome project and then edit them in Clipchamp. Real quickly, you can see I'm in the editor. We simply go back to record and create, and once again we want to grab the screen, hit record, switch to the tab we want, hit share, and then bingo, we are recording. You can hit play, watch your amazing footage happen, hit stop sharing when it's finished. And of course, when you're done with that, hit save and edit. Choose to put it in your folder like downloads, and you'll have one more piece of footage that you can play with in your project. Friends, once you've got all your clips recorded using those steps, you can speed up the clips. You can do anything you want to make your project look as cool as you want. Now, I have got a full tutorial for how to edit in Clipchamp. I will put that up above. Friends, I'm going to end this right now. I just wanted to show you all the cool techniques that you could use to capture your awesome Rube Goldberg projects and create videos that were absolutely epic to share with other people. Friends, I do want to quickly remind you about my website, HLModTech.com. I've got the page dedicated to Tinkercad, tons of amazing categories, and then also day one lessons, useful starters, and Tinkercad essentials. Friends, there is also the sweet built-in messaging tool. You can click that button, add your question, comment, or suggestion, and reach me almost instantly. I do also want to highlight the link to the Tinkercad community Discord. As you can see, we've got more than 700 members, and it is a fantastic place to talk everything Tinkercad. Finally, friends, if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. Please also hit that share button so more people can learn about HLModTech. Of course, friends, you absolutely make my day if you take time to leave a comment down below. And if you haven't subscribed yet, what are you waiting for? Smash that subscribe button. And last but not least, hit that notification bell if you want to be the first to know when there's a brand new video from me, HLModTech. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.